Thank you so much. I have about 8 minutes, so I'll just keep it very brief. Just to give you a snapshot of Bangalore City, we have a population of 14 million, that's 1.4 crores. We have a vehicle population of 12 million, 1.2 crores. It's almost 1:1. It's not good for a mega city. A good city like, say, Delhi or Mumbai have a ratio of 1:2 or 1:3. Incidentally, in January, we became the city having the largest number of privately owned vehicles in India. So it's no mean feat to regulate and manage traffic. We have a network of about 13,000 kilometers. We have 44,000 intersections. Unfortunately, Bangalore does not have a robust public transport system. Our public transport system consists primarily of buses, which move about 40 lakh people in a day. Roughly about 27% of our population moves on buses alone. We have a fleet of buses of about 6,400, which has not increased since 2003. So last 20 years, we have not added any fleet of buses. Our metro coverage is about 72 kilometers. Roughly about 8 to 10 lakh people travel in a metro. So basically, our public transport system usage is about 40 to 45%, not beyond that. And ideally, we should be at around 70% for any good metropolitan city. So what we thought was, given the existing infrastructure, given the existing constraints that we face, the pace of infrastructure is not able to keep up with the pace of vehicle population growth. The vehicle population growth compounded annual growth rate is at about 11% in Bangalore City. So it's exponential. We have added 60 lakh vehicles in the last 10 years, from 2013 to 2023. So, given these constraints, given the existing infrastructure, what can we do? So, since the buzzword is AI and machine learning, we thought, let us use that. And we created something called as Astram. Venkat will speak to you regarding that, what Astram does. Basically, Astram stands for Actionable Intelligence for Sustainable Traffic Management. Basically, we do big data analysis. We take data from a large number of data sources. We have a camera network of 9,000 cameras in Bangalore City. We have a lot of ANPR cameras, a lot of violation detection cameras. We have partnered with a few aggregators like Namayatri, Ola, who give us data. We have data coming from the National Highway Authority of India. Basically, there are 12 major entry points to Bangalore City. 8 of them have toll gates. So, we get data which is coming from the toll on a live basis. We have data coming from mobility aggregators or map-based services. So, all this data is crunched in, and our real-time data of our traffic police on the ground. Basically, we have about 5,600 staff working in Bangalore City. So, real-time live road conditions by way of vehicle being off-road, an accident, water logging, tree fall, processions, protests, anything which affects traffic is updated live on board. So, this data is crunched and we basically try to figure out the congestion index. And we have identified about 20 corridors of Bangalore City, which are high-density corridors. So, we ensure that the traffic moves on these corridors by way of the real-time live road conditions that we have. Yeah, so I was here. So, right now we have, we identify which are the congested areas. We try to do some interventions for those conditions. One important thing that we are doing is we are sharing information live to a lot of map-based services. Right now the data is live on Mapples. We are working with TomTom and Google. I think from April 1st, we should have that information on Google. They can use it for routing and whatever they want, because this is authentic live information of what is happening on ground in Bangalore City. The other thing is we do disseminate information on FM radio, and which is quite popular in Bangalore, and the social media handles. Some other things that we do is we take decisions on how what kind of vehicles or class of vehicles we allow at a particular time on the road. One important factor is the outer ring road, where we have the parking data available on the tech parks. So there are about 47 tech parks on outer ring road, which constitute about roughly about 80% of the workforce of the IT industry on the outer ring road. So the parking data tells us what exactly is the kind of movement of vehicles happening. So we have a baseline for outer ring road. If the baseline is exceeded, then we go for some other measures to take out vehicles from the road, like heavy goods vehicles are prohibited from entering. Then one day we had even light goods vehicles being prevented. We have a staggered exit plan also for about 9 of the tech parks, like EcoSpace, EcoWorld. In case it becomes severe, it has never gone to severe since September. If it goes to severe conditions, then we have a staggered exit plan for the tech parks. This all are based on the live traffic on outer ring road as well as the number of vehicles inside the tech parks. So apart from this, this will be explained by Venkat. It is a presentation. So this is the technological enforcement that we are doing. We moved away from physical enforcement where we actually stop a vehicle and check the documents or not. We said we will not stop anybody except for certain class of offenses which are considered dangerous driving. So we have gone from 33% in 2014 to about 98% in 2023. As in, most of our enforcement happens contactless, as we don't stop anybody. We have a large network of cameras where at the back, the AI at the back end is detecting about 13 types of violations. These violations are again automated. However, you know, the AI is not yet developed to have 100% accuracy. The accuracy is somewhere around 97% for certain offenses to about 47% in some other types of violations which happen. So the only manual intervention is for the at the back end where we do a validation of the AI. It helps us to do machine learning as well, because wrongly detected offenses are getting sent back. They are checked as well. So we have a drone network where we find congestion. We fly drones, 10 drones at 10 important corridors. We find out if accident has happened or if the vehicle has broken down using AI at the back end again. And like I said, the contactless enforcement we have gone to about 97 to 98% in 2023. ePath is a solution that we have developed for ambulances. Basically, ambulances plan their trips and we know exactly where an ambulance is moving. And if the ambulance is stuck for more than a minute, we get an automatic response saying that the ambulance is stuck there. So anytime the ambulance speed goes below 5 kilometers per hour, we get an update. So we move the ambulance. We help the ambulance to clear the traffic at that point. Right now, it's being used by Manipal hospitals. I think a fleet of 50 ambulances using it. Bangalore has about 3,000 ambulances, and we roughly do about 6,000 trips in a day. So we'll just deploy it. We just want to test it out, and beta testing got over, and it's working well for Manipal hospitals. So I guess we'll deploy it from next month onwards to all the other ambulances. So this is what I had in mind. So right now we are going for deployment of adaptive signals along with IBI Arcadis. We have selected about 165 signals where the fourth generation of adaptive signals using COSICOS technology developed by Center for Development of Advanced Computing is being done. Basically these signals will basically communicate with each other at the junction using computer vision. They are able to find out what's the load of a particular arm. So the signal timing given for each arm will vary depend on the load of at that particular junction. The other one is AI for enforcement. We have partnered again with IBI and a company called Nyan Technologies. Like I said, we had 9,000 cameras, so we are able to deploy AI at the packet to detect multiple types of violation as well as do automatic traffic and counting and classification. Basically, we are able to understand how many type of vehicles and what class of vehicles are moving at about 500 points in Bangalore City. So that gives us a way how traffic is flowing, and we'll have a baseline for the traffic flow in entire Bangalore City. Right now, we only for 20 corridors. We intend to go to about another 500 junctions in Bangalore City. This is what we call our drone network or visual area network, knowledgeable expert called Manki. Right now we have 10 drones. Next year we are going to deploy another 40. So we have a total of 50 drones monitoring about 50 junctions again. This will give insights into vehicle accidents and vehicle drones automatically, being off road. Again, adaptive signals, whole idea is to have multiple, variable traffic junctions where the signals talk to each other and they talk to the ambulances as well as the high priority vehicles by, it can be a VVAP convoy, it can be a fire truck, it can be an ambulance. They talk to them and they give priority to them. It has been deployed in other cities where it has shown considerable increase in non-peak hours of vehicle traffic speed or the throughput increasing anywhere between 17% to 30%. So we are hopeful in non-peak hours as well. And the test was successful in a corridor. So we have deployed this in about 165 junctions this year. So we have collaborated with a lot of other agencies as well. We have mobility aggregators, we are working with IIC. What I realized was that we are custodians of large amounts of data, which is unfortunately not processed into meaningful information. So our data is being shared to a lot of entities who are then interpreting it for their this thing, and it is being used for policy as well. So good, accurate, authentic data is being done. So we act like a data lake. We are sharing the data with IUDX, which is the Indian Urban Data Exchange, and that can be used by anybody. We are giving free, of course, we are not charging a single pipe or anything. We work with Nimans, Bloomberg, and World Resources Institute for the road safety initiatives. And I just want to say, artificial intelligence is the buzzword, but if you put too much stupidity inside, you get artificial stupidity out. So, I think we have to be careful and ensure that we progress in the right direction, and somewhere I feel the AI is the buzzword. We need to keep it in check and ensure that I always feel human intelligence is far superior in terms of common sense. Right? We keep that in mind and we harmonize human labor as well as artificial intelligence. I think we'll have a good time. Thank you so much.